water relations. Okay, so here in the plant water relations we are going to see, that is about how the water it mainly transport, that is here from the root, then again stem, up to the leaves. So see, that is here the water absorption how takes place, then again some physiological processes we are going to see, etc. Okay, so first we see that is about the water which is present in the soil, that is it mainly absorb by the plants, that is through the roots. Okay, so here the in the plant cell there is about 90 to 95% of the water is present. Okay, so here the water it mainly present in the soil, it mainly absorb through the root hair. Then again the root hair, it is the single cell structure. Then again it transfer to the epidermal cells, that is known as the epiblema cell, and then again from the epiblema cell it again transfer up to the cortical cell. Okay, so first we see about the properties of the water. So we have seen that is properties of the water. That is here the water is the most important property, that is it is the solvent, that is many solute get soluble in the solvent, that is water is the solvent which is in the liquid form, okay, at a room temperature. So it is the best solvent. Then here the pH of the water is always neutral. pH of water is the neutral. Then here it is the best transporting medium, that is here through the water. Then again some minerals, म्हणजे पाण्यामध्ये जे पाण्यात जे सॉइल मधून जे वॉटर ट्रान्सपोर्ट होतं त्याच्या बरोबर बरेचसे मिनरल्स जे असतात तेही त्याच्या बरोबर प्लांट मध्ये ट्रान्सपोर्ट होतात. सो इट इज द ट्रान्सपोर्टिंग एजंट फॉर द मिनरल्स अँड द सम मॉलिक्युल्स. देन अगेन हियर इट इज द रॉ मटेरियल फॉर द फोटोसिंथेसिस, दॅट इज द फोटोसिंथेसिस इट इज द प्रोसेस इन विच हियर द प्लांट प्रिपेअर देअर ओन फूड मटेरियल फ्रॉम द सीओ टू अँड द H2O. So here the H2O, that is the water, it is the raw material for the physiological process, that is the photosynthesis. So here see, that is here the water it mainly see, that is the structure, if we see the water, that is here H2O. So see, that is here the oxygen, it is mainly the negatively charged, and here is the hydrogen on the both side, it is the positively charged. Okay, so here the hydrogen and this oxygen, that is it is the one water molecule, and this one water molecule bind with the another water molecule, see that is here the oxygen, here again the hydrogen, here again the hydrogen, and here is the negatively charged. Okay, here is the positively charged. So here this water molecule can be bind with this water molecule, that is by some attractive force. Okay, and here so attractive force which is produced, that is in the form of the bond, that is the hydrogen bond. Hydrogen bond. Okay, so here the water, it is the dipolar. So why it is dipolar? That is in the water there is the one positively charged, that is having the hydrogen, and the negatively charged is of the oxygen. Okay, so here the oxygen is negatively charged and here hydrogen is the positively charged, and therefore there is binding takes place and the bond formation between the two water molecule is the hydrogen bond. And due to this presence of this hydrogen bond, here the water it shows the specific characteristics or some different properties. That is, these different properties are, that is the water, it is having the heat, high specific heat. That is the most important characteristic or the properties, that is it shows the high specific to the heat. Okay, so we can see that is the water having the specific boiling point. Okay, so here it is the high to the specific heat. Then here the water, it shows the high heat vaporization. That is, at the particular temperature here, the water vapors are produced. Okay, so here due to here the water, it converts into the vapor. So it is the high heat vaporization, and then that is here the high heat fusion. So high heat fusion. So these are some properties of the water. That is why, because due to there is the presence of the hydrogen bond between the two water molecule. Okay, so the water, it shows the dipolar dipolic condition. That is here the dipolic means here one hydrogen having the positively charge while the oxygen is the negatively charge. Okay, then next that is about here the how the water, this water, it gets absorbed. Okay, so here the water, it mainly having the some physical characteristics, that is the specific heat, heat vaporization, heat fusion. And here the water, it mainly transport, that is into the root hair, then again from the root hair it transfer into the plant body. That is here the water, it mainly transfer from the physical process to the biological process. Okay, so see, that is here the how the water is a transport. That is also the water having some another specific characteristics. That is the water having the surface tension. Surface tension. Water having the surface tension. Then here the water having the high adhesive force. And it is also having the cohesive force. Cohesive force. So see, that is what is mean by the adhesive force. That is, it is the attraction between the two dissimilar molecules or the substances. So dissimilar substances means what? There is the attraction between the water and the lignified wall. Lignified wall of the cells. So these cells are of the xylem cells, that is the tracheids and the vessels. Okay, so see, that is here. See here, that is the structure of the vessel is like that of the pipe. Okay, through which here water is transported. So here the wall of the vessel, it mainly made up of the lignin. And here water which moves. That is, there is the attraction between this water molecule and here the lignin. Okay, so here is the attraction between two different, that is the lignin wall and the water molecule. So it is the adhesive force. Then what is meant by the cohesive force? That is, cohesive force means here attraction between the two similar molecules. So which are the similar molecules? That is the water plus water. Okay, so here the attraction between the two water molecule, that is known as the adhesive force. Okay, and due to the cohesive and the adhesive force, here the water, it mainly make the column in the vessels and the tracheids, and due to which here the water, it mainly transport. Okay, so it is about some properties of the water. Then next, that is how the water is a transport. That is here there is one absorbing organ for the transport of the water. We have seen also that is here, which is the absorbing organ, that is the rooty. Absorbing organ of the water, that is the rooty. Okay, so here the root tip, we have discussed that is here the root tip. It is mainly having the root. At the tip portion there is the protective covering. It is known as the root cap. Okay, then above this root cap here is the region that is which is made up of the immature cells, but these cells having high capacity of cell division. So here these immature cells which are present, that is this, it is known as the zone of cell division. Okay, or here in the it is the zone of meristematic cells or the meristematic tissue. Okay, so here it is also known as the meristematic zone or the meristematic cell, or it is also known as the cell division zone. Okay, so or it is also known as the region of the cell division. Region of the cell division. So at this region here, there is the cell division takes place. So here these cells are immature and it having the high capacity of the cell division. Then above this cell zone of the meristematic region, here is one zone, that is it is the zone of elongation. Zone of elongation. So here in the zone of elongation, that is here the enlargement of the cell takes place. Only the enlargement of the cell takes place, that is here the cytoplasmic content of the cell increases, and due to which here in the zone of elongation here the enlargement of the cell takes place. Above the zone of elongation, here is the some specific zone, that is in which here there are the many root hairs are produced. Okay, and through this root hair here the water is absorbed. So this region is known as the zone of absorption. Okay, so at this region here the water is absorbed. So this region is known as the zone of absorption, and this region there are the root hairs. There are the root hairs. So with the help of this root hair the water is absorbed. And above this here there is the maturation zone. So here at this maturation zone, here the cell gets mature, that is there is the differentiation of the cell takes place. How the differentiation of the cell takes place? That is here at this region here only the cell gets elongate, enlargement takes place, but there is no differentiation between the cell, that is the permanent tissue. So in which there is a simple tissue and the complex tissue are produced. So simple tissue, these are the mainly parenchyma, colenchyma and the sclerenchyma. These are the simple tissue, while the complex tissue, these are mainly the xylem and the phloem. So out of which here the xylem, it is the water conducting tissue, and the phloem, it is the food conducting tissue. So here at this region, that is this region is known as the maturation zone or it is also known as the zone of or the region of the maturation. Okay, zone of maturation. At this region here the cell differentiation takes place, and here when the water is absorbed by the root, then again it transfer through the meristematic zone, that is this maturation zone, and this maturation zone in which there is the xylem, water conducting tissue, through which here water is conduct up to the stem and then again up to the leaves. Okay, so it is about the absorbing organ, that is the root tip. Okay, so single we see that is how the structure of the root hair. So root hair is the main part that is through which here the water is absorbed. Okay, so see that is here the outermost wall of the root. It is made up of the epiblema cells, or it is the epidermal cell which is known as the epiblema cell. So see that is here, these are the epiblema cells. Okay, so these are the epiblema cells. outermost layer. So here one epiblema cell, it protrude, and here from which here there is the formation of the root hair. Okay, so here it is the epiblema cell. And here through this one cell of the epiblema, that is here the wall gets protrude and it produces the elongated that is the root hair. This structure is the root hair. So here length of the root hair is of the 1 to 10 millimeter, 1 to 10 mm. Okay, so one specific characteristic that is in the root, it is the single cell, unicellular. Root hair is the unicellular. Okay, so it shows the single nucleus. Like this here, single nucleus. And it shows the large vacuole. So, here is the vacuole, which is the large vacuole. Then it is surrounded by the cell cytoplasm. And here, the outermost wall, it is the cell wall. Inside which here there is the cell membrane also present. So here is the cell membrane. We have seen in last lecture, that is how the structure of the root hair detail. Okay. So here, see, that is here the vacuole is large, due to which here the cytoplasmic content, that is the protoplast, okay, and the nucleus, that is here, they gets arranged towards the periphery, that is they push out towards the periphery. Why? Because here is the large vacuole, म्हणजे त्याच्या आत मध्ये जी पोकळी असते, सेल सिंगल सेल आहे हा, बरोबर आहे, आणि त्याच्या आत मध्ये जी वॅक्युअल जो असतो तो लार्ज वॅक्युअल असल्यामुळे वॅक्युअलच्या कडेने सगळे जे काही प्रोटोप्लाझम आहे ते प्रोटोप्लाझम त्याच्या कडेने असतं. मग त्या प्रोटोप्लाझम मध्ये काय काय असेल, देयर आर द माइटोकॉन्ड्रियन, ओके, अदर सेल ऑर्गनेल्स, एंड हियर इज आल्सो द लार्ज न्यूक्लियस. ओके, सो हियर इज द न्यूक्लियस, देन अगेन देयर मे बी द माइटोकॉन्ड्रियन एटसेट्रा इन द प्रोटोप्लाझम. सो नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट से दैट इज अबाउट द सेल वॉल. So the cell wall is mainly made up of the two layers. Cell wall of the root hair is made up of the two layers. That is the outer layer. Cell wall is made up of the two layer. That is the outer. Outer, it mainly made up of the pectin. Outer layer is made up of the pectin, while here the inner layer is made up of the cellulose. So here the pectin and the cellulose, these are some hydrophilic substances. Pectin and the cellulose, these are the hydrophilic substances. And here the water, it mainly first process we are going to see, that is the diffusion. So here, sorry, imbibition. So in which here the pectin and the cellulose, these are the hydrophilic substances, these are most useful. So cell wall is the freely permeable. So permeable means what? That is through the cell wall it allows the solvent, then all the solute can be passed through the cell wall. Okay, so here the cell wall is permeable, but here the cell membrane is the selectively permeable. Selectively permeable means what? That is through the cell membrane, here only the solute or the solvent can be selected solvent or the solute can be passed through the cell membrane. Okay, so the cell membrane is the selectively permeable, while the cell wall is the freely permeable. Okay, so here, see that above, that is the cell wall and the cell membrane. So here the root hair, it is mainly the unicellular, colorless, unbranched, and it is the short-lived. Okay, so it is the short-lived, so it is known as the ephemeral. Okay, so it is the short-lived. Short-lived, so it is known as द इपीमेरल. इपीमेरल. ओके, सो इट इज अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द रूट हेयर. ओके, सो इट इज द एब्सॉर्बिंग ऑर्गन. ओके, इन विच वी हैव सीन दैट इज द रूट टिप स्ट्रक्चर एंड हियर अबाउट द रूट हेयर. ओके, देन नेक्स्ट कंसेप्ट दैट इज हियर थ्रू दिस रूट हेयर विच टाइप ऑफ द वॉटर इज मेनली एब्सॉर्ब. सो विच टाइप ऑफ वॉटर इज ट्रांसपोर्ट दैट इज और एब्सॉर्ब बाय द रूट हेयर. See here, that is first upon the water it is absorbed through the root hair. See here, it is the root hair. So here the water which is around the root hair, that is here as the soil particles, okay, in which here water is present. So here the it is a micro environment present around this root hair. It is known as the rhizosphere. And water it mainly absorb from this rhizosphere by the root hair. Okay, so here the root hair it is the mainly absorb the water. That is which type of is water absorb by the root hair. So see that is here the water, that is the types of the soil water. Which type of water is present in the soil? So there are the four types of the water. So first is the gravitational water. Another type, that is it is the combined water. Fourth is the, third is the hygroscopic water. And fourth is the capillary water. Capillary water. So here the combined water and the hygroscopic water, it mainly known as the bound water. These are the bound water. Okay, so why these are known as bound water? Because they are tightly bind. Water molecules are tightly bind. That is in the combined water and in the hygroscopic water. Okay, so here the gravitational water means what? That is this type of the water. It mainly percolate deep in the soil. That is here we have seen that is the uppermost layer is made up of the fertile soil. Okay, then again below which there is the rock. Okay, so here when the rain water falls, here the water percolate in the fertile soil and then again it gets downward up to the rock. Okay, and here at this region here the root tip does not reaches. Okay, and due to which here the water is not, that is gravitational water, it is not absorbed by the root. Okay, so here the gravitational water, that is it mainly present deep in the soil, and up to this water here the root tip does not goes or the does not reaches. Okay, so here the gravitational water is not absorbed by the root. Then again the combined water, this combined water it is mainly hydrated forms of the oxides and the silicon, oxides of the silicon and the aluminium. So here the combined water it is mainly made up of the hydrated oxides of the silicon and the aluminium, that is it is combined, and due to which here the water is not absorbed by the root hair of the root tip. Then next that is the hygroscopic water. That is this hygroscopic water, it mainly tightly bind with the soil particles. Okay, so if we see these are the soil particles, the hygroscopic water is tightly bind around the soil particles. Okay, so here the soil particles absorb the water or imbibe the water, and due to which here these water molecules are tightly bind with the soil particle, and due to which here the hygroscopic water is not absorbed by the root. Okay, so here these three types, that is gravitational water, combined water and hygroscopic water, these three water they does not absorb by the water. So that is, these three type of the water are not available for the absorption. Okay, so which water is available? That is the capillary water. Okay, so see what is mean by the capillary water. So the capillary water means what? That is, here this water is present, and that is in between the pores of the neighboring soil particles. Okay, so see, that is here, and suppose it is, these are the soil particles, many soil particles like this. Okay, and in between the soil particles there are the small pores like this. So here, so these are act as a capillary. These are act as a capillary. Okay, so here the water, it mainly present in the capillary. Okay, or the pores which are present between the two soil particles. Okay, it is known as the capillary water. And here this capillary water only absorbed by the plants. Capillary water is only absorbed by the plants. Okay, so here the water which is available for the plant, that is, in which we have seen, that is, remember only, capillary water is absorbed by the plant, and hygroscopic and combined and the gravitational water is not absorbed by the plant.